My beloved people, my YouTube, Periscope, Tanika Maria here, coming out here on a very rainy day in North Carolina. It is raining cats and dogs here. As you're coming in, let me know in the chat. I'm back on my laptop, so I can't tell. Let me look at this phone to see. Okay, let me know that you're in the building. Put your name and where you're coming from in the chat box, your city and state, or wherever you're coming from. My name is Tanika Maria. I'm all about helping you get real, be healed, and move forward in emotional wholeness, peace, and clarity. Hey there, Miss Sunshine. That's right. Long hair, don't care. My hair grew a whole foot, lady. Sure did. Amen. Had to change it up a little bit. Blessings to you. Good to see you. Good to see you here with me on today. And as you're coming in, definitely feel free to share, invite, give hearts. My name is Tanika Maria. I'm a certified Christian life coach, but most importantly, I'm a woman of God, child of God, and I'm passionate about emotional wholeness and relationships, all things about emotional healing, mastery. Because right now in times that we're living in, we got to have resilience. Hey there, Harolyn from Birmingham, Alabama. Good to see you, lady. Good to see you. Blessings to you. And please do share as you're led to do so. And I want to share briefly on today the concept of emotional hygiene. Emotional hygiene. And as you're coming in and if you're led to do so, put that in the chat. Emotional hygiene. What is it and how to know when you need it? Well, we all need it every day. You know, we like to have physical hygiene. We take our showers every day. We don't mess around with that. We try to keep our homes clean. We keep our bodies clean. We're making sure that we're doing that. Well, guess what? We have to do it up here. We have to have mental hygiene. Come on. We have to have hygiene in our hearts, in our souls, our emotions. Your soul consists of your mind, your will, and your emotions. Blessings to you, Pastor Ron. Good to see you. Your mind, your will, and your emotions. So emotional hygiene is about, yes, thank you for putting that up there, Miss Sunshine. Emotional hygiene is the same concept. It's like a daily practice of being aware of what's going on inside of me, what's going on in my soul, what's going on in my emotions, what's up? You know, it's that awareness capacity. So let me define that really quickly for you. I think I wrote it down here. I can't remember what I wrote. Emotional hygiene is being mindful. I can't even read my handwriting, you guys. Mindful of your psychological health and adopting brief daily habits to monitor your trauma and wounds whenever you sustain them. Let me say that again. Emotional hygiene is being mindful of your psychological health. And this is a standard definition. I would say your mental health, your emotional health, your spiritual health, the health of your soul, right? So emotional hygiene, being mindful of those things and adopting brief, and it doesn't have to be some long drawn out ritual that you need to do, but brief daily habits that you can do to monitor the trauma, to monitor the daily offenses, the wounds, the words, whenever you sustain them. So we're talking about emotional hygiene is a practice where you daily commune with God, you daily commune and sit with yourself. Go check that scope I did on 5 tips on how to heal and feel better now. Check that out. But it's a daily process of being like, okay, God, what's going on? Why am I feeling some kind of way? They said that to me. I felt this. I perceived that. And now I'm sad. I felt this. I perceived that. They said this. I saw that. Now I'm a little bit hot. Now I feel some kind of way. I'm walking around triggered. I'm walking around feeling very irritated and very on edge. What's up? So emotional hygiene is keeping track of that. Emotional hygiene is the daily habit of not letting all that mess pile up on you, because you know what? When it piles up on you, you're going to get in trouble. That's right, Miss Sunshine, is adopting brief daily habits so that you can monitor and quickly move forward from the daily trauma. It's not the little foxes that destroy. It's the little things that pile up on us. And the next thing you know, you're walking around offended and wounded and bitter and mad. And it's not one thing. It's a whole bunch of little stuff that's piled up. And now we're in a season where we got a lot going on. We have this pandemic. We have the status of our elections here in the United States. We got our own dramas and traumas in our own personal lives on top of what's happening nationally and globally. And now we're carrying that. We feel it as a collective. We feel it as a country. We feel it as a community of faith. If you got any semblance of humanity, any type of any awareness in your spirit, you feel what's going on in the world and in the country, and you're sensitive to it. And so you have to have a daily soul care practice in order to clean emotionally, right? And so we're going to talk about some brief ways. So let me give you some signs. Now I'm getting an emergency weather alert on this phone here. I don't know if you guys can hear that. But at any rate, let me give you some signs that you need some emotional house cleaning. And as you know, as I always do, I back up everything with scripture, right? And so your heart is the seat of your emotions. It's your soul. It's where everything is here inside of you. Remember always that you are a human being having a spiritual existence. You are a spirit. You are human, right? Your spirit, I'm getting it backwards. You're a spirit and you're having a human experience, but you're a spiritual being and you have this soul. And the Bible says, guard your heart above all else, for it determines the course of your life. Proverbs 4:23. As it is in the natural, so it is in the spirit. And when you fail to heal and order on the inside, this is what we're talking about, emotional hygiene. When you're failing to clean it, and ordered on the inside, the same way, if you go 2 or 3 days and you don't take a shower, you're going to start stinking. You go days and weeks and months and you don't take care of your emotional hygiene, guess what? You're going to start stinking spiritually. You're going to start stinking. People will notice that. People will know something is off with you. So as it is in the natural, so it is in the spirit. And when we're carrying emotional baggage, unprocessed pain, trauma, daily offenses, negativity, and fear, it piles up on the inside. And so these are some signs. That's right. Daily soul care practice. These are some signs that you need emotional house cleaning or emotional hygiene. And if someone wants to type it in, that would be awesome. Number one, you hear a song, you smell a certain smell or perfume, or, you know, you smell something, you see a movie or get around in a certain movie or go to a certain place, or you get in a certain situation and you start feeling feelings. You see a Facebook on a picture on Facebook. You see something on Instagram, just a song or a scent or a smell. And now you get triggered. Now you want to cry. Now you're down in la la land. Now you're going down memory net lane and nostalgia. And it's a place that you really know you don't need to go. But now you find yourself there. Or sometimes you see somebody and it triggers up all of these feelings. You see a picture of them on Facebook. You get around in certain situations and it just takes you there. And now you want to lash out. Now you may want to cry. Sometimes you may want to start acting funny and feeling some kind of way. You may want to even lash out. That's sign number one. You need emotional hygiene. That's a sign that you need emotional house cleaning. Thank you for putting that up there, Miss Sunshine. Number two, and if you see yourself in any of this, you can start putting a one in the chat. If you see yourself in any of that. Number two, another sign that you may need your emotional hygiene needs to step up your emotional hygiene game is if you overreact to the least little thing. You're projecting your feelings and blowing something all out of proportion, way bigger than what it should be. You're taking a small situation, a small incident, and now it's just, you've turned into this big old thing and it's this big deal when it's really like this and you've made it into a mountain. That's a sign that you need emotional hygiene. That's a sign that you need emotional house cleaning. This is something we do daily. Daily we go to God, daily repentance, daily forgiveness, daily like looking at myself and being aware, right? Number three, and I know I'm moving quick because I know I don't have a lot of time. But number three, thank you for putting that up there. Holding grudges and unforgiveness. Now this is really, really big. really big. Because see, we can be holding grudges and things like that and not realize it. Sometimes we're still holding on to petty offenses and little stuff and big stuff, but it's really, really big. You're holding a grudge. You're feeling some kind of way about somebody and what they did and what they said. And it's a weight. Unforgiveness is a weight. Unforgiveness blocks money. Unforgiveness blocks blessings. Come on. Unforgiveness, we carry it in our body. Sometimes the weight that we carry, and I'm talking about physical, natural weight. Sometimes it's not metabolic. Sometimes it's not because of what we're eating. It's literally because of the unforgiveness. Why do I say that? Because we're eating emotionally. We're using the food to numb. Right. And sometimes the question to ask yourself is not the weight, but to ask yourself, who is it that I'm carrying? Who am I carrying in this extra weight, this extra 10 pounds, this extra whatever pounds? It's who you're carrying in your spirit. We're, again, you've heard me say this on my broadcast. Humans are the only mammals that eat for reasons other than true hunger. We don't eat from hunger. We eat from appetite, or sometimes we eat from our emotions. You don't see a lion, or you don't see a tiger that's like, I'm angry, sad, and depressed. Let me go kill this zebra right quick. No, I know that sounds crazy. Because that's literally what we do. That's what we do as humans. So three, if you're holding grudges and people in your spirit and you carry them in your body, you might want to look at that. That's a sign that emotional hygiene is needed, right? Number four, if you're always replaying, always ruminating, staying in that place of rumination and rehashing, you got a lot of the voice. I call it the tormenting voices. Sometimes it's the voice of the accuser. Sometimes it's just a lot of mental chatter, a lot of stuff. You're waking up in the morning still thinking about something that happened 4 years ago. You're waking up in the morning, you're still thinking about what happened. And that thing is old and dead. And the Lord says, behold, I make all things new. Remember ye not the former things, neither consider the things of old. For behold, I'm doing a new thing. Now it springs forth. But we're so stuck in the rumination and the rehashing. And we're still trying to look at it from 50 different angles. And we're still in shoulda, coulda, woulda. And if you're in that place, that's a sign that you have some emotional house cleaning to do. Amen. And I know I'm moving quick and I hope this is helping somebody. You guys are listening. That's why y'all are not typing in the chat. But I need to know that this is resonating. Can someone at least say yes in the chat? I need several of you all to say something in this chat to let me know that you are hearing and getting what I'm saying. Besides Miss Sunshine, who's being so faithful, remembering the old things and replaying the alternatives. That's a big, you know how much emotional and mental energy we spend in the past? Do you know how much of that energy you're spending thinking about what happened that could be used for your forward focus, that could be used for what God has for you now? Our God is a present future God. He's not a present past. He's present future. God is in the now. Now faith is. Not now faith was. Now faith is. And some of us got that look back anointing. Remember Lot's wife? Like my mentor says, remember Lot's wife. And I don't have time to be in that look back anointing. I don't want that. And neither do you. Amen. I'm glad this is helping somebody. Amen. Thank you. Thank you. So if you're in that place where you're always ruminating, rehashing, going over what happened in that situation and what you said and what they said and what you should have did and what they should have said and what you wish you had said instead of saying what you said, and you're just going around, blah, blah. If you're in that space, that is a sign that you have emotional hygiene that you need to take care of. That's a sign of emotional house cleaning. And how do you all think I know these things? It's because I live this. It's because it's what I have been going through. It's what I have endured. And so I'm just, the only difference is I get out here and talk about it, right? That's the only difference. So, and when you're in that place of ruminating and rehashing, it makes a bigger and bigger imprint in your mind. It literally makes neurological pathways in your brain. There's a science behind it. It gets bigger in the memory tree of it and how your cells work in your brain and how the superior high level way that God created us, the more you think about it, the bigger it gets, the deeper the rut gets into to your brain and how those neurons and how those memory trees work. And it just becomes this big thing in your brain. And the Bible says, be it unto you according to as you believe. So if you believe this thing and you're doing it, you're just making it deeper in your head. You're making it deeper for yourself. So that's sign number four. Sign number five. The inability to be vulnerable, relational issues. And so basically what that means is if you want a real relationship, you got to be willing to be seen and you got to be willing to be vulnerable. You got to be willing to open up yourself and show the real you. But if you can't do that, if you're always perpetrating, trying to stay a little bit hard, trying to stay a little bit distant, trying to protect yourself, trying to keep things surface, making all these inner vows, well, I can't trust women, they're catty. You know, all men are dogs and this, that, and the other. Well, then you're keeping your heart hard and you're not being vulnerable. Then we'll be the first one to say that there's no good people out there that you can't trust. Well, part of that is you. Part of that is our own inability to be vulnerable because we're trying to protect ourselves. And God is your protection. God can protect you. God can keep you. And if you do get hurt, you have tools. You have God. You're seen. You're safe. And you're supported in God if you actually believe it. So you don't have the heart in your heart and stay distant, right? But if you're unable to be vulnerable and to open your heart, that is a sign that you have some emotional hygiene issues. That is a sign that you have some emotional housekeeping to do. That's a sign of trauma. It's a sign of needing to be healed. Number seven, here's the seventh one. Recurring patterns. If you see a recurring toxic pattern over and over again, such as procrastination, always being late. If you're one of the people that can't ever get anywhere on time, always procrastinating, always waiting to the last millisecond to do anything. That's a sign. That's a sign. And it's an ingrained pattern. It's an ingrained habit. And it's just so many subtle variances of that, but it's ingrained. And it's something, you know, this procrastination, being late, being overwhelmed, always in that cycle of frustration and avoiding stuff to the last minute, distracting yourself. You know you're supposed to be doing something else, but you're over here on your iPhone scrolling Instagram. I'm reading these comments here. You know you're supposed to be doing what God said, but you're sitting here watching TV. And then now, oh, you know you're supposed to have this deadline done, but you keep putting it off. Those are all signs. And it's fear. Procrastination is rooted in fear and anxiety. It's fear. But there are signs. Those are the signs that you need some emotional housekeeping. You need emotional hygiene. So I hope this is helping somebody. And of course, more obvious signs would be like dramatic mood swings, bouts of depression, the anxiety, and things of that nature. And so if you see yourself in any of that, I just want you just to take a moment and to begin to cultivate. Definitely catch my scope on the five tips on how to heal and feel better now. But definitely take the time to be aware of your pain, to have compassion for yourself. And these are basic, like the stuff that I'm saying right now about taking time for yourself and having compassion for yourself. That's emotional first aid. So I told you the signs you needed emotional hygiene. Now let's talk about first aid. That first aid is coming in the form of going to God. That's coming in the form of sitting with yourself and saying, you know, God, what's going on? Being aware of what you're feeling, not numbing your feelings or distracting yourself. And then just another big way that can help you with this emotional hygiene is simply looking at how you're perceiving your various situations. Like, what is the spin that you're taking? What is the meaning that you're assigning this? You know, one thing can happen to someone else and they're fine. The same thing happens to you and you're down in the dumps for 2 weeks. It's the same situation, but two different perceptions, right? One person can go through the exact same type of trauma, you know, get the house burnt down, lose a job, and they pick back up and they bounce. Another person can go through the same exact situation and their sight, their perception, how they see themselves, how they see God is totally different and they can't recover. So look at the perception, look at the meaning that you're assigning to it. take something simple, like somebody didn't like your post on Instagram. And you know, a lot of times we're doing a lot of subtle stuff and subconscious stuff on social media, but somebody didn't like your post. And now you're feeling some kind of way. They never like my post. I always like their post, but they never like mine. And you can take to mean that two ways. They really don't like you and are ignoring you. That's the negative perception. Or you can take it like I don't show up in their feed. I'm not showing up in their feed enough. And so they really don't see me. And they're preoccupied and busy. Which perception, which meaning that I assign to that behavior, what's going to make me feel better? The more positive meaning, but we naturally deviate to the most negative meaning and we injure ourselves. We create our own self-inflicted pain. We create our own self-inflicted torment by the meaning we assign to other people's behaviors and actions. And a lot of times people are so unaware and they're so caught up in their own world and they're so caught up in their own head and in their own feelings, they're not paying you any attention. But we take one isolated incident, we assign a negative perception. We assign a negative meaning to it. We run for the hills with it, get into rumination and rehashing, assigning judgments and meanings that don't have anything to do with the truth. Now we're hurt and now I need emotional hygiene because now my day is messed up because I've assigned a negative meaning to something that was totally innocent. Does this make sense? Y'all, I hope y'all are listening and getting this. This is how we torment ourselves. This is how we get ourselves in trouble emotionally. This is how all of the petty offenses and petty feelings and feeling some kind of way and being hurt and sad creates all this problem for these problems for us. So I'm here on this afternoon, on this rainy afternoon in North Carolina, just to drop these nuggets before you. Just wanted to give you something to think about on today. Ways that you can be more aware of how you need the emotional hygiene, how we need emotional housekeeping to keep ourselves up. So I encourage you. Yes, it does. And glad this makes sense for you, Harolyn. I encourage you to go before God and make it a daily habit, a daily soul care habit where you sit with yourself. And even as you go throughout your day and you feel different kind of feelings, like be aware of it. Don't just try to stuff it or hide it or numb it, but be aware of what's going on inside of you and how you're feeling. And like, God, is this, Lord, separate the truth from the lie. God, help me separate the truth from the lie. Lord, let me not be perceiving and reading into stuff more than what it is. God, don't let me injure and torment myself with these thoughts that are not true. God, don't let me spin this perception around to the most negative thing about this person just because I saw something, I felt something, I got some kind of impression. God, look at my heart. Create in me a clean heart, oh God, and renew a right spirit within me. And a lot of times we can solve our own problems if we just take the time to do effective emotional hygiene and go before God before we start making up these stories, because I call them stories too. We got a lot of vain imaginations and we make up a lot of stories in our head about why people said stuff, why they did stuff, and we're not God. We can't read people's minds. We don't know what's going on with them. We can speculate and pontificate all we want to. But at the end of the day, the only person we're accountable for are the thoughts that's in our head and in our own heart and what's coming out of our own mouth, right? And no matter what other people have done or said that's causing you to have poor emotional hygiene, everything that's causing you to feel some kind of way, all of those, and go back and catch this as you're coming in. I hope you're sharing this. Share this, invite. Walk real quick before I leave. If you don't follow me, I encourage you to follow as I continue to share on these topics. But just be mindful of the fact that you are a powerful co-creator in your own life. It's your own daily habits, the actions you take, the words you speak, your own behaviors that's creating your life. It's not the devil. It's not other people. They impact it, right? And people can influence your life and they can do things bad to you and all of that. But really, the most powerful person in your life is you. You are a powerful co-creator. You are a speaking spirit. And every time you speak, creation occurs. You create when you have a habit. You're creating by your behavior. You're creating by every action and by every word and by every persistent thought that you act out, right? So it can't be everything can't be the devil. So to the degree that we operate in effective emotional hygiene, that's the degree that we can walk in emotional resiliency, that we can walk in peace, that we can walk in clarity. We don't have to operate in chaos and confusion. We don't have to be anxious and tore up. I don't have to be sad. It can be hell in the United States with the elections and the pandemic, but I can still maintain my peace. I can still maintain my sanity. Yes, you can. Yes, you can. Real quick, and I'm going to wrap this up. I feel like I need to share a little bit here. Let me look at these notes because I get worked up, you guys. A lot of the reason why we have such poor emotional hygiene is because of repeated trauma after trauma after trauma. And I want you guys to be clear that trauma is not always some big, bad, gigantic thing. What's trauma for you may not be trauma for me. Let me give you the definition of trauma. Anything, trauma is anything that overwhelms either one, some, or all of your emotional, mental, spiritual, and physical systems. Let me say this again. Trauma is any situation or incident that overwhelms your emotional, mental, spiritual, or physical systems. It can overwhelm either one of those or all of it. So a trauma is anything that has changed you such that you're not the same person after it happened. Let me say that again. Trauma is anything that has changed you such that you're not exactly the same as before it happened. That could be a breakup. That could be a divorce. That could be losing your job. That could be a friendship ending. That could be a house fire. That could be a health issue. That could be being sexually abused as a child. That could just simply be feeling run down and having cycle issues if you're a woman. It could be your husband cheating on you, your boyfriend cheating on you. It could be your children acting crazy. It could be your job being super stressful. It could be your child flunking from school. It could be drama at church. It could be your business not kicking off. It could be watching your parents having a dysfunctional marriage. It could be having a weird, jacked up relationship with your mom. It could be feeling guilty about some abortion you had. Any of that. And what's trauma for you may not be trauma for me. But it's anything that has hit your system that overwhelmed you, that you're not the same. And if it's not dealt with, and it doesn't mean that you're crazy, it means that you're a human being. And again, what's traumatic for you may not be traumatic for me. So we have to get to the point where we don't diminish or minimize the things that's happened to us. We have to accept it. And if you've gone through any of these things, then you have to be very careful with your emotional hygiene. You have to be very intentional about your healing process. You have to be very intentional to go before God and Lord, here I am. God, I'm daily repenting. And repentance doesn't mean that repentance is just simply changing your mind. It's just simply a turn. God, I was here, but now I turn there. I was thinking crazy here, but God, I turn here. God, it's a correction. It's a shift. And it's a daily forgiveness. Lord, create in me a clean heart. God, I forgive and release that as an act of my will. Yes, I was offended. Yes, I'm sad. Yes, that hurt me. But God, daily, when the memory comes, when the flashback comes, when the chatter comes, when that mind chatter, when that comes, God, I choose to forgive. I choose to release that because God, I want to be free. There's nothing like emotional freedom. There's nothing like being liberated. There's nothing like being free. Who wants to be in bondage to their disappointment? Who wants to make an idol about all the bad stuff that happened? Sometimes we sleep with it. We don't want to let it go. But emotional hygiene is the process of daily releasing. Just like you daily get in that shower and you wash away the dirt of the day off your body. Emotional hygiene is like, Lord, my emotions want to hang on because I want to protect myself. I want to harden my heart. I don't want to be hurt again, God. But Lord, I know, God, I got to have an open heart. If you want to receive and give love, if you want to feel safe and seen and supported, you're going to have an open heart for that. Mm-hmm. And you can't close it up with your hurt, which means I got to have hygiene. I got to have emotional hygiene. And we can't do that in our own strength. We need God. Amen. Amen. So I'm praying that this blesses you. And I'm so excited to just come out here and share with you. And if you haven't shared this, go ahead and do so. And again, my name is Tanika Maria, all about helping you get real, be healed, and move forward in emotional wholeness, peace, and clarity. And I invite you to come join me on next Friday, November 20th at 7 o'clock p.m. I'm having a special Zoom masterclass, and we're just going to go in. I'm going to have live Q&A, mentoring, and I will be talking about all of these things, how to be safe, seen, supported, maintain your serenity and stability in times like this. If you're struggling in these areas that I've talked about, and you just need that extra support, and you want something where you feel safe, you can share certain things. And this is for my ladies. This is for my ladies. But click the link in my bio, 7 o'clock p.m. Eastern Time. You'll have access to the recording, access to me in a private session. And I'm only having limited spaces for that. You can sew whatever amount as you're led to do so. I don't have a set price, but I highly, highly, highly encourage you. If the Holy Spirit is drawing you to this and drawing you to be a part, definitely want you to sign up for that, because I want to unpack further and give you more tools and language so that you can daily keep your soul clean and daily just go before the Lord. And see, life is hard. And you know, it's not going to get any easier out here in these streets. There's a lot of things coming, and we can see the nature of the landscape of what we're living in now. And you're going to need your head and your wits about yourself. You can't afford to just be losing it emotionally. You have to be able to be stable in times like this. And so that's what I'm about. Definitely want you to come join me. Know that God loves you. I want to leave you with this. And again, if you haven't shared it or followed me, I encourage you to do that. Just know that you're safe, you're seen, and you're supported. Now it's up to you to choose to believe that. It's up to you to choose to believe that. But that is a core desire and a core need of every human being. And a lot of times we don't feel safe. We don't feel seen. We don't feel supported. We don't feel safe with our hearts. We don't feel like no one sees us, much less supports us. And if you're in that place, that survival mode of being feeling suspicious and anxious and rattled, then I encourage you to get on this masterclass. But I want you to begin that process. When you pray tonight, go to God and ask Him, God, do you see me? And am I safe? And do you support me? Am I supported? And that answer is yes. That answer is yes. So blessings to you. Blessings in abundance to you all. Know that you're seen. Know that God is aware of you and that He is mindful of you. And I look forward to coming out here again soon. Blessings to you all. Take care. Bye-bye.